My day job involves repairing and calibrating medical equipment, and occasionally we run staff training sessions to show how problems can crop up and how they can be solved. To do this, we need to fool the equipment into running normally, even though there's no patient attached. For one particular demonstration, the equipment needs to see a static pressure of 200 to 300 millimetres of mercury, which is overlaid with a moving pressure of maybe plus or minus 20 millimetres of mercury. My task was to find a way of doing it. I was rooting through the junk box for inspiration and I came across this aluminium conrod. It was rescued from an air pump a while back, probably one dating from the 1980s, and I only kept it because unusually it's made from metal. This is a modern one, which is essentially the same, but somehow it's more plastic and not quite as nice. By removing an M4 screw, the end washer and fibre piston ring come off, leaving just the big end and the bearing. From this starting point, it looked like I'd be making some kind of oscillating piston arrangement, and I decided immediately I wouldn't be trying to make a perfectly sealed piston from scratch. I have a plentiful supply of small syringes that work really well and only cost a few pence. If one becomes worn or leaky, I can just fit a new one. Given that the first element of the project was recycled, I thought it'd be interesting to try and make everything else from the junk box too. I needed a barrel for my syringe, and for that I'd use this scrap door handle. I used the bandsaw to chop a lump off, then over to the lathe to turn down the diameter. There were no measurements here, I just went for what I thought looked okay. You might notice I swapped tools partway through, as the swarf wasn't really behaving itself. This little tool will turn, face and chamfer all in one. Next came some steady drilling to open out the middle to take the syringe barrel. After measuring the end of the syringe, I cut a recess the same diameter and a little deeper than the flange. And then I drew around the end of the syringe as a guide, ready to cut the rest of the recess. Knowing I'd want to do some more turning before I'd finished, and that my chuck's not very repeatable, I left the work in place and moved the whole thing over to the mill. Once centred, I used two different sizes of end mill to plunge in. The result isn't exactly the same shape as the flange, but it's close enough. Next, I needed to make an end cap to keep the syringe barrel fixed in place. For this, I used the diaphragm rescued from a scrap gas regulator. Once drilled to separate the brass from the rubber, it was over to the lathe. As my three jaw was still busy, I used the collet chuck to set up a click spring super glue arbor. This is a really versatile way of holding small parts that only need light work. Full credit to Chris for sharing this. I reduced the central boss so that it'd be a nice fit with the recess on the barrel holder and trimmed off the outer rim. A little heat breaks the superglue bond, then it's back over to the mill. I drilled and tapped the end cap and fitted a couple of M2 screws. The whole thing was then taken back to the lathe to give the end cap a final trim and to open up the central hole big enough to clear the syringe plunger. I cut the barrel holder from its spare stock and trimmed up the rough end. This is how all the parts fit together. Final job for this part was to cross drill and ream the barrel so a pivot axle could be fitted. Join me in part 2 when I'll be making the plunger holder and the fixing brackets.